I want to thank God, my family, and the people of the Commonwealth of Kentucky. I stand here tonight at the end of an 18-month job interview filled with gratitude, humility, and more determination than ever. To all those listening in this room and around Kentucky, whether you supported me or not, I promise you this. We will protect your family. We will defend your rights, and we will back the blue. For the neighborhoods in West Louisville struggling to address violence, for rural counties and small towns fearful that Washington's radical agenda is attacking our values and our way of life, for the parents across Kentucky who lay awake even this evening worrying about their kids that they may fall a victim to the poison that we're seeing flow from over a porous southwest border, and for the law enforcement leaders who risk their lives every day, who will be out there on dark country roads and answering calls this evening when we're in our beds safe tonight. I see you, I hear you, and I will represent all of you. And to Representative Stevenson, Colonel Stevenson, we may come from different parties and bring different philosophies, but I appreciate her service to our Commonwealth, and I appreciate her service to this nation. Please join me in honoring that. As Attorney General, I look forward to working with anyone, regardless of party, who will stand with our law enforcement, who will protect our families, and who will help me put drug traffickers and violent criminals behind bars where they belong. Getting elected today was a team effort. What a privilege to be part of such an incredible Republican ticket. We spent many hours together at Lincoln Day dinners, Fancy Farm, and on the bus tour. And I can tell you that Allison, Mark, Jonathan, and Mike are all first-rate leaders with tremendous integrity and tremendous competence. Above all, I'm proud to follow in the shoes of an extraordinary Attorney General, my good friend, Daniel J. Cameron. As you know, he is a man of faith, of character. He is a once-in-a-generation talent. I always knew that Daniel was destined for many great things, so much so that we named our kid for him. I pause for a moment because there are enormous shoes to fill in following the footsteps of our 52nd Attorney General. Our soon-to-be treasurer, Mr. Medcalf, likes to say that sometimes shoes are just so enormous they can't be filled, but you seek to walk in them, to follow behind them, to seek the counsel of those that came before you. And I can certainly say that in regard to our 51st Attorney General, Daniel Cameron. Ronald Reagan was very fond of saying, there's no limit to what you can accomplish, the amount of good that you can do, if you don't care who gets the credit. Now, that's much easier said sometimes in politics. This victory, it isn't just mine. It is yours. It belongs to all of you who prayed for us, who contributed precious resources, who welcomed me into your homes. The best part of this campaign was meeting the extraordinary people from every corner of this Commonwealth, and the barbecue, of course, the barbecue as well. To our Commonwealths and county attorneys, some of whom are in this room, to our sheriffs, to our chiefs of police, to my brothers and sisters in the Fraternal Order of Police, the FOP, those who stood up early and often to support this campaign, this is your win. You won't just have a seat at the table. We will focus on supporting you every day we serve in the Attorney General's office. Now, to my team, from volunteers to the best in the business crew at RunSwitch PR, thank you for allowing me in this campaign to be the beneficiary of your considerable talent. You made me better. I want to say a special thanks, where is he, to Gavin Henshaw. A young man who has become like family. He spent countless hours in the truck with me from the mountains to our river counties and everywhere in between, always with a smile, and as many of you all know, always professional, always with an encouraging word. Gavin has made his native Paducah and his family very proud. And most importantly, friends, to my amazing wife, Ashley, and our... incredible kids. Yeah. They made one sacrifice after another for this moment. We're not a perfect family. We're not perfect individuals. But I am deeply grateful that God gave them to me. As I close, before someone files cloture on this filibuster, I'm in awe of this journey from a kid growing up in rural West Kentucky who dreamed of one day becoming an FBI agent and serving my country, fulfilling that dream and serving both domestically and abroad, to the medical challenge that left me paralyzed and leaning quite literally on my wife and medical team to learn to walk again. To Senator Mitch McConnell, who changed the trajectory of my professional and personal life. Make no mistake, friends, I didn't make this happen. I do all things through Christ who strengthens me. I stand here today because of his blessings and the love and support of the people in this room. That's a great former colleague there. Thank you, Judge. I'm honored to be your next Attorney General. And friends, may God protect the men and women of Kentucky law enforcement and the people of our Commonwealth.